efficiency, ease of use. Words we ascribe to how we want things in our lives to operate. Technology has drastically reduced the need for certain manual tasks, and some very enterprising organizations would like to reduce that even further.
Artificial intelligence, or AI for short, can be found in nearly every area of our lives, from its rudimentary forms such as a thermostat to highly sophisticated computer systems. But there are things that don't necessarily use AI, like a ceiling fan or a dishwasher. But that's changing. Scientists think that by connecting devices or things to the internet or even to each other, it'll allow for the integration of AI, which could boost efficiency and prevent problems before they arise. The Internet of Things, as it's called, is poised to revolutionize how we interact with our environment and with others. Gartner research estimates 8 billion connected things will be in use by the end of 2017.
Stephen Gold has a track record of leading connected enterprises. He's currently doing that with Honeywell, and Atlanta will be a key player in the company's work in the area of IoT, as you'll see in today's executive profiles.
So tell me about your childhood. You grew up in Chicago, correct?
I did, and I can still remember a holiday when I was a little kid getting up in the morning and running down the stairs, and my favorite toy was a toolbox. And it was, you know, it was the plastic tools, but didn't matter, right? I felt I had arrived on the scene, and it kind of progressed from there. I think my parents were aghast when I literally dismantled a bicycle they had bought me because I wanted to see how it works. It turns out it's easier to get it apart than put it back together. But from that, I just had this fascination with mechanical things.
And ended up going to University of Illinois in Champaign?
I did.
So upon graduating from Illinois, what was the first job out of school?
I worked the internship before graduation designing valves for the Henry Pratt Company. Water valves, nothing real spectacular, but very necessary. And it gave me an appreciation certainly for mechanical engineering and manufacturing. And so when I graduated, I actually went back to be an engineer in valves, but this time designing class 2 containment valves for nuclear facilities.
Oh boy.
So great opportunity, visited nuclear power plants, learned an incredible amount, but I realized very quickly that you know, really my passion was really more on the broader business side.
When you moved on to IBM, how did that prepare you to go into a management role at a company with such an iconic brand? Talk about that experience of going to a company like that.
I had actually joined a company back in Chicago, a company in the analytics space called SPSS. And it was, for me, a large company. It was about 300 million, about 1,200 employees. I had been an entrepreneur. And no sooner did I literally join the company that they were acquired by IBM. So.
Right.
You find yourself literally thrust into a very different environment, not one in which you picked, but one in which you have to accept. It was a little bit of an eye-popping experience, because I always assumed that big companies weren't entrepreneurial, and quite to the contrary, what you find is that the big companies can be entrepreneurial. It's really a cultural question, and so it opened, my perspective into what big companies are all about, how they operate. Much better appreciation, for the value they bring.
Watson's become sort of an interesting part of the IBM brand. Do you have a good Watson story to tell us?
Yeah, probably my favorite Watson story was relatively early on. We had focused in on health, and I was down doing a project with MD Anderson in Houston, one of the large cancer research centers.
Right.
And a doctor was actually sharing a story of using Watson for a particular patient that proved exceptionally challenging, and how Watson was able to identify a distinct pattern that no one had detected. And as a result, we had a pronounced effect on that person's life. Mm-hmm. And I literally found myself in tears realizing that the job that I was doing, technology, was having such a pervasive effect on society.
People in Atlanta may know Honeywell, they may know the name Honeywell, but they may not know a lot about what they're doing here. Why don't you kind of explain what Honeywell is doing in Atlanta?
Yeah, Honeywell is an amazing organization, and all of us have seen the products and heard of the products, but until I actually came aboard, I never really had a strong appreciation for the diversity of the portfolio. Everything from jet engines and brake systems on planes, to building automation solutions for fire and safety and environmental control. It's an amazing organization, a century in its making. But the one thing that all those things have in common is they're physical. They're things that we actually produce. And for the last decade, we've had this fascination as humans with the digital world. And we're starting to see this convergence between the physical and digital. And so what's interesting about the work that we're doing in Atlanta, you know, is we're really the catalyst to bring that physical and digital divide together and start to think about how do you take simple devices and instrument them and make them more intelligent and connect them in a way that they can do things better towards better outcomes. And that's really the work of the Atlanta team.
You chose Atlanta. What about Atlanta? And what's working, and how is the city performing for you in terms of being a business center?
Atlanta stood out for a number of reasons. In fact, Georgia stood out for a number of reasons. You know, it's a great destination in terms of, you know, where you want to set up shop as an individual, is where you want to invest in your family. When you look at the university system, the type of curriculum and courses really lent themselves to the things that we were doing around big data and analytics, right, and AI.
What do you see happening in terms of Honeywell as being a corporate citizen here?
Where we're able to participate at the elementary and high school level in the various STEM programs, to collaborate with the universities, you know, to foster retention of talent within the state. We just announced a plan to allow individuals here to gain the benefit of a repayment program for student loans, so that we will cover up to $10,000 of their student loans. Honeywell's over a century old company. But the most important thing is that what we're working towards, and certainly what the Atlanta Center is working towards, is this notion of critically connected.
Right.
Moving beyond simply synchronizing, a wearable with the phone to measure our steps, to what we can do to improve, from a health point of view, from a safety point of view, from a sustainability point of view, what we can do to improve the quality of our lives.
Honeywell is in the process of expanding its software development center in Midtown. It'll also be the headquarters of a $10 billion home and building technologies unit. Around 200 employees could be up and running there soon. Full expansion is said to happen over the next 5 years and could create around 800 jobs. Up next, they're not quite in a league of their own, but they're certainly holding their own. Find out how the Atlanta Falcons rate on the NFL value chain. Plus, which bank has moved up the ranks to become the second largest in Atlanta? And still to come, setting a strategy to not only be a premier location for entertainment production, but also a leader in content creation.